This is the second LED that burned out in my keyboard. This is a T-Dagger something or other. It works very well. I mean, Otemu blue switches and okay keycaps. But yeah, this is the second LED that burned out under the I letter. So this is kind of, yeah. So here it is. Here's the LED that's not lighting up. I can press it and nothing happens. It just stays like that. So yeah, this is crap. If I press it hard enough, maybe it will light up a bit, but yeah, it's gone. So I want to replace it and I'll try using an LED from an RGB LED strip and the green one, I think. I don't want blue or red, that's too bothering for the eyes. I'll just get the green one and yeah, I have to mark it so I will know which one is the burnout LED. I want to, oh, I just marked the key. That's I just marked the back of the switch. That's the easiest way. Okay, so the one that's black, that's the defective one. Let's pull out the plug and maybe turn on some lights to see something. Yeah, so this is the, where it is? Oh, here. This is the defective one and it's marked which one is the positive. So first let's get an LED from this strip with scissors. These are all marked which one is the green. This is a green one and oh, which one is the positive and which one is the negative in this weird circuitry? So the 12 volt positive is this side, and the resistors are connected to it. Yes, the resistors. So the positive comes in through these resistors here. And it comes into the top of the LEDs. Okay. So that must be the positive, the top. Which is the thinner thing in the middle. Thinner, shiny thing. So let's cut open an LED from here. I don't want to solder or something like that. It's not really feasible. Soldering on these thin circuit boards. Well, these are really circuit boards. And yeah, let's get off this silicone coating if I can. It's not really easy, but I have to get it off. It's not sticky, really. But it's on there, so I don't know how I separate it successfully. On the end of the LED strip, I used to just bend the strip, and then it will separate from the silicone rubbery thing. So here it's a little harder. Oh boy. I don't know if I can do it on camera. With more force? How should I do this? Or just cut it off? Yeah, let's cut it off at the contact. Like that. Maybe then it will be easier. Oh, I got a hold of it and it's gone. No. I almost thought that I got it. small parts are coming off, but the whole thing doesn't want to come off. But I need it to come off for a successful replacement. It can't stick out too much from the original size. A part of it came off. Now, yeah, it's coming off. Okay. It's kind of hard to do it, but yeah, I got the free LED from an otherwise defective LED strip. I don't know what's its problem, but I put it in the junk pile a long time ago. So yeah, I think it's mostly cleaned, and there are the soldering points on the two ends. There is still some goo there. What can I do? Here it's mostly free, but still needs a bit of pulling. Man, somebody with tiny hands should do this. Yeah, maybe cut it now, and then it will be easier. Oh boy. Maybe. Okay, so now we have to check it out, if it works, if it survived the manhandling, what I just did to it. Let's diode measurement, and it has to turn up on slightly. If I put the positive to the positive and negative to the negative. Like that. Oh, the contacts are not free yet. Oh boy. But yeah, this reminds me, I can work on it easier if it's on the bench. And take a needle, maybe, to scrape off the silicone. This is not a good. I don't know. I don't know what I'm doing. But yeah, success is a possibility here. That's important. So the outcome can be good. Okay, I think I got it off there. Yes, I did. And the other side, without damaging anything, hopefully. Like that. It's coming off. So the story behind these cheap LED strips is that they screw up the coating. It's not complete. In some places it doesn't cover the contacts and the LEDs. So they can't sell it at full price. So they sell it at about $1 a meter. And yeah, I just buy them. Because I don't care about weatherproofing. But yeah, if you want to do something DIY like this, clean it, it's a bit harder than a simple RGB LED strip without the coating. So let's see. The positive to the positive and negative to the negative. Okay, it lights up. Perfect. Wait, it's red. What the hell did I do? I wanted green. What? I did get the green one. Look. It's here. It says green. So this strip is messed up. Oh boy. Oh boy. I'm and this is the red one. And I, it says red, but I can bet you $1,000 that this is the this is the green one, probably. Whatever, I don't care. I will just put on the red one. At this point, I don't really care. So let's cut off more of the strip. So the solder is more, the soldering point is more exposed. So I can just, yeah, like that, and on this one too. Like that. Is it off? Yeah, there is still more. But it's okay, I think. So the positive is the small part. And okay. It will be red. Whatever, I don't care. So where's the defective one? No. What am I doing here? Oh, here it is, the marked one. And I'll just break off that LED. I don't care about it. I'll just break it off. I don't know how. Pliers or something like this. Nah, it's not strong enough. So, yeah, let's try some pliers here. Excuse me why I brute force this off. If it can hold on to it. Can it? No, it can't. Maybe the tip? Nope. So let's use a blade of some sort. Screwdriver. Maybe. Let's try a screwdriver. Put it in there and get it off. Oh boy. Why is it so hard? No, it's coming off. Yep, it came off. And the other part will go in the other direction. We'll have to get that out. It's somewhere under the keycap. So, yeah, that's not ideal, but yeah. So, how will this fit? That's the question. Like this. Nope. I'll have to cut off some of that solder. Or move it with the soldering iron. Like 1 millimeter. It needs one additional millimeter to be in the right position. How can I do that? I need to think and be right back in another video.